Now, Men at Work's Down Under and the children's song Kookaburra are two of Australia's most popular songs. Now, famously, they crashed into each other in a very expensive court battle.
Released in 1980, Down Under was adopted as a punchy anthem for Alan Bond's America's Cup Raiders. But fast forward to 2010, and Men at Work were sued over the flute solo in their hit song. A court ruled copyright was infringed because Down Under reproduced a substantial part of Kookaburra, a children's song written in 1934 for a Girl Guides competition. This is what the two songs sound like together.
And writer Trevor Conomy has probed the amazing story of these two songs, and he joins us now from Melbourne.
Yeah, good morning, guys.
So, Trevor, what do you make of this court decision against Men at Work?
Well, like a lot of people, I thought it was unfair, to say the least. It's an objective look at both the songs, but most people seem to consider that the outcome was wrong.
And I share your view, Trevor. I think it's absolutely outrageous that the estates of often long-dead songwriters are suing current working songwriters for different riffs or chords or whatever that are universal to so many songs. And these things are being decided by judges or juries with no musical knowledge at all. Do you think there should be some prerequisite that people should at least have some working knowledge of how music works before they're able to make these decisions?
Well, in the court case itself, there were music experts, musicologists, and they certainly had a knowledge of what they were talking about. It's a complicated area, but it often just comes down to emotional reactions, which band you prefer and which way you want to swing when you're looking at it from the outside.
I listened to both of them and honestly, I think it's a real stretch. I can't see how they could possibly say. I mean, I think that's completely unfair.
Well, there's a snippet of a melodic line. I mean, for one thing, one song, Kookaburra Sits in an Old Gum Tree, is in a major key and is on a major chord for that riff. And the Men at Work song, it's on a minor chord for that riff, which completely changes the sound of it.
Totally.
And that's something that a layman or a judge wouldn't understand.
Don't songwriters borrow from each other all the time, though?
Sure.
Yeah, these points were brought out in the court case itself.
And Greg Hamm, who was the flute player who played that solo, how did he react to the court finding?
Well, I haven't been too close to people who knew Greg Hamm, but by all reports, he was not in a great way to start with, and this certainly didn't improve his frame of mind. It was a very sad outcome, a tragic outcome.
Yeah.
A ridiculous outcome. And of course, there's plenty of big names that have been caught up in similar things. There was George Harrison's My Sweet Lord. There was, of course, the very famous Vanilla Ice borrowing Ice Ice Baby from Under Pressure by Queen and David Bowie. Do you think, what's the message for songwriters here? Should they just not write anything to be on the safe side? Or how do they avoid having being sued the pants off for borrowing things? What do you tell them?
Look, it's a funny thing. I was walking up Swanson Street in Melbourne here the other day and I could hear some music coming out of a shop and I thought, have I been spending too much time with this song? Because that really sounds like Down Under. I went back and had another listen. It had a reggae beat. It had a very familiar chord pattern and even a little flute riff in it. Now, it wasn't Down Under, and just in case there are any copyright people listening, it was reminiscent, let's say, but you've got to wonder, one day is the world going to run out of new musical ideas altogether?
Yeah.
Trevor, thanks so much for joining us. Really interesting chat. Thank you.
Thank you.
And Trevor Conomy has nailed down the story of Down Under and Kookaburra in his new book. It's available in all good bookstores right now.